Hello, I'm Miguel Gomez with HIV.gov, and thank you for taking the time to view this video. CROI in Denver, Colorado is going to be starting later today with an opening plenary. We are very lucky at HIV.gov because right now we're going to talk to the sixth director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, Dr. Jeanne Marrazzo. You just started in September, mm-hmm. and we are so grateful for your service, and this is the first time we get a chance mm-hmm. to talk with you. And I just have a handful of questions for you. My first question is going to be, CROI is about to start. What are you interested in learning about, listening to this week?
Yeah, well, thanks, first of all, for having me. It's wonderful to talk to you, Miguel, and to NIH.gov.
HIV.gov.
HIV.gov. You know what I mean.
Absolutely.
It's really great to be here. And I will say that CROI is one of my favorite meetings for several reasons. For one thing, there's so much going on, and there's science across the spectrum from discovery to implementation. There is a fantastic representation of community folks here, and that's always been the case. So there's a real sense that the science that's presented here has the potential to change practice, which I know is really important to this audience. It also has the potential to change guidelines and guidance for managing people who are living with or at risk for HIV. So it's a fantastic meeting. I think a few of the sessions that are happening this week that will have data that will be of interest to this audience and to me will include some data on infants who were started very early on antiretroviral therapy and the course of their natural history after that. We expect to hear some data on long-acting antiretroviral therapy, particularly in populations that have adherence challenges. Very much looking forward to that, because as we think about options for people for both prevention and treatment, we really need to design regimens that work for people. Maybe you can't take a pill every day. You know, maybe you don't want to get a shot that works mm-hmm. for 3 or 6 months. So I think that's going to be very exciting. We have already heard about the REPRISE study, so everybody knows what an important contribution that was, and the recent change in mm-hmm. the HHS guidelines, which is going to dramatically, we hope, improve the metabolic health of people living with HIV. But the other component we're going to hear about that gets to taking advantage of the fact that REPRISE actually enrolled a very diverse population, mm-hmm. and so we're going to be hearing about specific risks for cardiac outcomes in mm-hmm. particular, metabolic outcomes in Black people and in women, and basically highlighting that those groups are at increased risk for adverse outcomes related to not regulating those metabolic parameters as well as we could. Those are just a few things. I guess the other thing I really can't wait to hear relates to my strong interest in women's health, mm-hmm. and that is a presentation on the dapivirine vaginal mm-hmm. ring in pregnancy. So those are just a few things. Be sure to tune in.
Well, it is an exciting conference, and I know right after you are going to talk to some early career investigators. Mm-hmm. And many of us know that you have a long-term commitment to mentoring and supporting this community. But could you remind our viewers why it's so important to support this community?
It's incredibly important, and I could not be more sincere when I say that for many reasons. One is that it's a very tough time for young people to go into this field. The economics are challenging, the public challenges and sometimes negative energy that we have experienced during the pandemic. We're still dealing with HIV/AIDS with a stigmatized disease in many places. So being a researcher or a provider who works on a condition that is stigmatized, that can evoke some negative feelings, energy output, can be really tough. And especially when you're trying to get, often people are trying to get a family started, they've got a lot of loans, they've got a lot of debt, they're trying to get their lives together. So despite all that, I just want to say that this has the potential for being an incredibly rewarding career. This is probably one of the most interdisciplinary areas that you could choose to work on. This conference is a fantastic example of true interdisciplinary work. I was just in a, as you mentioned, the early part of this conference for session for young investigators. And just seeing so many people interested in everything from the capsid getting into a human cell to how we're going to get the products to people in the community so that they actually use them is really amazing. So, and also, you know, we really need people to take our jobs. Like, I don't want to do this for the next 20 years. I'm totally committed. I'll do it as long as I can and I can have an impact. But, you know, we have not always been attentive to training the next generation of people. And we succession planning has not always been our strength, I would say. So please stick with it. And we look forward to supporting you every way we can.
Well, thank you for that. And I know that you're heading off to actually speak and present at the Gathering of the Young Investigators. So we want to let you go. But Doctor, I really want to thank you for your service again and your time. And I want to remind our viewers that they can follow HIV.gov this entire week to learn more about what's news coming out of NIH, NIAID. And I'm going to be joined this week with some presentations live from CROI with some of my other colleagues. But if you want more information about what's happening here, please visit HIV.gov. And thank you.